Hello everyone, welcome to the second episode of this series, The Era of VTuber, Building One with Python Unity. So this episode, we will go through the procedures of building a TCP connection to transmit our data from our Python program to our Unity program, and building a Unity project to host our 3D avatar, our 3D Unity jar avatar. So in the last episode, we have gone through the facial motion tracking or the pose estimation procedure. So you can check the videos in my channel. So all of the source code and the project can be found in my GitHub page here. So one of the ways to transfer our data from our Python program to Unity is to use the TCP/IP protocol. So why do we need this type of file transmission? It's because our programs, one in two separate programs, one is the Python one and one is the Unity one, and we have to build a connection between these two programs, and the TCP/IP protocol can do this job flawlessly. So TCP protocol is one of the protocols to transmit the files and the data across devices like computers, servers, and clients. And from its wiki page, it provides reliable, ordered, and error check delivery of a system of bytes between applications running on host communicating through a IP network. And so in our applications, our Unity program will be the listener, which is the server, and it waits for the message to come. But the Python programs will be our sender, which is the client sending the information to the Unity side. And so the server must be listening, which is passive open for connection requests. So in order to make this program run smoothly, to start the Unity program first before start the Python program. So before establishing the connection, an IP address and a port has to be declared before. So in the main program, like here in the init TCP, we have to declare our address. So the address has two parts, which the first part is the IP and the second is the port. So the IP, we can think of the IP is a large apartment which has many flats. And in order to allow the postman to send the letters to the correct addressee, you have to give the postman a full address, but not just the apartment. Like each of the flats in the apartment is the port. So you can declare different ports. So here we will declare the port 5066 to be our target port, and you can change the variables here as well for other applications. And so we'll be sending the raw facial and other facial expression data like blinking and mouth movement, which these will be introduced in the upcoming episodes using the TCP network. So before diving into the course here, we are going to set up the Unity environment first before sending data to the Unity, and we'll be using the Unity Jam 3D model as a demonstration. And the tutorial of setting up the live 2D model will be introduced in the next episode, so stay tuned for this series. So here we will be creating a tutorial project, so we'll launch our Unity, and we can download the Unity package from its official website opened here. So we're creating a new 3D project. So by the way, I'm using the 2020.3.12 F1, so we can use other versions of Unity. So we'll be naming our project called 3D Avatar Tutorial, and choose the 3D one and then create. While waiting for the creation, then go to the Unity Jam official website, which is here, and download the Unity 3D model. So press the data download here and change it to English first, so you can read the introduction of the Unity Jam and some of the license. In this particular tutorial, it follows the license here. So press the agree and click this button to download. And so click for the first one, Unity Jam 3D model data, and press the download button. And you can save the Unity package in whatever position you like, for example, the download folder. But since I've downloaded it, so I won't download it once again. We wait for the Unity project to be created. So after creating the Unity project, and we can of course adjust the layout to what we like, but here we will import the downloaded Unity package by clicking the edit, the access and import custom package here, and we'll be importing the Unity Jam package here. And so we'll wait for a pop-up to confirm what assets that we are going to import here. Okay, so import all. And here we have to wait for like a few minutes. Okay, so the import has done and you can see the folder Unity chart right here. And so we can find the model in UnityChan and go to the prefabs and go to UnityChan without the dynamic one. And you can drag the UnityChan prefab into the scenes, reset the position, change the layout first. And not necessary. Okay. But here you can see that there's an error in the script. And by looking out, you can see that the automated script has an error. And so we can fix it easily by clicking it first. And you will pop up the script. And so the error is that it imports the policy one. But the policy one is already in the security one, so you don't have to import it. And so just delete the policy word and save it, and the error is gone. Wait for reloading. And so after importing the package and the model, you can adjust the camera settings to have a better view angle. So you can adjust the camera settings and adjust the rotation of UnityChan as well to let it face to the camera first and let it zoom closer a bit. Adjust the height. Okay, so in order to create a green background for post editing, you can choose the black solid color and change the color to green or whatever color you like. So you get a green background here. And also you can tune the aspect ratio for better viewing purpose. So that's it. And last, we'll drag the script in the project here, so we'll find the Unity assets and the scripts like UnityChan 3D, drag all this to create a folder named script first, and we'll drag all this script here. Some of the script will be used for creating the UI, and you can check it in the sample project included in the GitHub as well for setting up the sample and simple UI. So here we'll drag the UnityChan controller into the UnityChan prefab, and we'll disable the idle changer and the phase update here as well. And so if you want to keep the auto blink active, you click the is auto blink active. Otherwise, if you don't want it, and you can disable it here. Save it. That's all. The setting is finished, and you can press the play button and ready to receive the information from the Python using TCP here. But I won't play it because I've already launched another one in the live 2D. So after setting up the project, we'll go through some of the code reviews, and we'll review the main Python and as well as the UnityChan controller. So import the corresponding package for setting up the TCP connection with the Unity, and the main function will be the init TCP and the send info to Unity. These two functions will be doing the job here. So in the init TCP, which called at the beginning of the main function, you create a socket first by declaring the address. The 127.0.0.1 will be the local host, which is preserved for the local connection within your device, like within your computer. And so declare the port as well, creating a socket using these parameters can be found in the Python documentation, and at last call the connect function by connecting the address and return the socket here. And so you can send the information to the Unity using this send info to Unity function called at the end of the main function here. You send the info to Unity by passing the socket and as well as the information pad in a tuple. Okay, so you send the information corrected to 4 decimal places in a kind of string. and you send it here, and you can print the message for debug, and we'll go through the Unity Chunk controller right here. So in the Unity side, you have to initialize the TCP stub here as well. Make sure you use the same port or otherwise you won't receive the information. And like I said before, the Unity Chunk is the listener side, and so it has to be opened before starting the Python side. Then you got the init TCP here, and you create a background thread for receiving, well, for listening for any new information. And you create a buffer, which is in terms of byte for storing the, for buffering the information. And so you receive the information by encoding in ASCII and get the incoming data and return it as a string. And the string is separated, so each value in the string is separated with a space bar, just like CSV, each value is separated with a comma. So you split all the string into a substring and pass the string back to the float and store it in the parameters here declared. So for controlling, we use the head rotation function. We do the net, we do the rotation head net to control the movement of your head. And so before that, we have to declare the transformation of the net and as well storing the initial rotation, which in Unity is the contournian class for rotation purpose. So declare the init rotation as this value, and then go to the head rotation. You calculate the pitch roll rotation, and you can clip it to a rotation angle for preventing any kind of aggregated movement here as well. You claim this value. And at last, you apply the rotation by multiplying the new quaternion based on the initial quaternion, which is the way that to apply rotation in Unity here. So lastly, you have the onAveration create function, which will be called automatically when you close the app or you close the application. So you abort, you close the thread when the application creates. It seems that Unity will not create the thread by yourself, so you have to terminate it by yourself. And so that's it. That's it, the code review. And I hope this video will be useful for you. So in the next episode, we'll be talking about setting a Unity project for the live 2D model from scratch, and we'll do some code review as well of the corresponding controller script. So at last, you can check the project here in my GitHub in the description as well. Give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed the video, and share your video to your friends who are willing to establish your own VTuber career. And so I will see you in the next episode. Thanks for watching and have a great day.